Hi, I'm Alpha. I'm the support guy from Fide Innovations. This is a Chromebook Pixel 2013. It was indeed a piece of computing history. When it was first debuted in the year of 2013, it was the best Chromebook out there that you could buy. The spec and price tag was way above all of the other ones. Even in today's perspective, the industrial design is still pretty slick and the performance is still quite solid. Unfortunately, it has reached its end of life and Google has decided to stop supporting the ChromeOS inside. So the last running ChromeOS is 69 without Android and Linux support. So if you happen to own one of these machines, presumably you like to continue utilizing the well-made piece of hardware. You now have the option to install FydeOS for you, tailored for this piece of device. The installation and configuration process can be slightly intimidating if you are new to tinkering Chrome devices. In today's video, I'm going to demonstrate to you how.
In order to utilize full feature FydeOS for you can offer, you will need to remove the firmware ride protection screw from the Chromebook Pixel 2013. You need a small Phillips screwdriver for this step, and I'm sure you have the confidence to crack open your device. If not, just follow the link to IFIXIT for a detailed step-by-step guide. Once you have the back cover opened, it helps to also remove the battery just as a precaution. The location of the ride protection screw is on the edge of the machine as shown here. All you need to do is to unscrew it. Next, redo the steps in reverse order to put the battery and the back cover back on.
If you have not already done so, you will also need to transition your stock ChromeOS onto developer mode so we can have access to the system files to perform what is needed. This step will wipe all your data on your existing ChromeOS installation, so please do back up before it's too late.
To begin the transition process, once the ChromeOS UI is initialized, press the Escape, Refresh, and Power keys simultaneously on the keyboard. The system will automatically switch to what is usually called recovery mode, where you will see a yellow exclamation mark on the screen. At this moment, press Ctrl and D keys together and you will see some information about transitioning into develop mode. Press Enter to confirm it.
Once you've done that, ChromeOS will immediately reboot and display a developer mode warning message. Press Ctrl and D keys together again to skip it, and ChromeOS will continue to boot into out-of-box experience as if you just did a power wash. You may now go ahead finish the OOBE process per usual.
Once you are landed in a desktop, you can verify if you are in developer mode by launching the browser and press Ctrl and T together. In a crushed shell, enter the command shell, where you will see a green bash shell prompt rather than some error message, like so. In the next part, things may get a little tricky where you will be replacing the stock firmware of your Chromebook Pixel to a third-party compatible firmware maintained by Mr. Chromebox. The reason we need to do this is to provide FydeOS the required hardware virtualization interface to enable Linux subsystem where the stock firmware cannot support such feature. You can find more information about this third-party firmware right from Mr. Chromebox's website. Just Google Mr. Chromebox and you will find it. Actually, the command you will need can also be found from Mr. Chromebox's website. Head down to Firmware Utility Script and copy the entire line as shown here and paste it onto your bash shell by right-clicking the mouse or double-tapping the touchpad. Hit Enter and let the script do its work. Assuming a decent internet connection, the script will finish downloading the required blobs very quickly and present a nicely formatted menu for you to choose from. Note that the script also tells you that your firmware write protection is disabled as displayed here. This is just to confirm that the first step you took to remove the screw had worked. The one thing that we are interested in the script to do for us is number 2 here, to install a UEFI full room firmware. So now let's press 2 in the prompt. It spits out some information and warning messages for you to confirm. Read it and press Y to continue. and again, press Y again to confirm. It's now asking you to make a backup of your current stock firmware in case things go sour or at one point you wish to put back things as they were. It's highly recommended just to have a backup option. Press Y to proceed with the backup and you will need a separate USB storage drive to store the backup firmware dump file. We'll skip this for the purpose of this demo. The script will now download a correct compatible firmware ROM file for you from Mr. Chromebook's server, and the flashing process will automatically begin once the download finishes. Under normal circumstances, this process will sail through in less than 2 minutes. However, under a very unlikely event that the flashing process errors out, do not power off your Chromebook Pixel 2013, or you may very well break it. Try redoing the entire process again from pasting the script into your shell. If the same error comes back again and again, try get in touch with us or Mr. Chromebook for assistance. You will see a green success message once the flashing process completes. Press Enter to return to the main menu, where you can now press R to reboot your Chromebook. If all goes well, you shall see a Chromebook logo that looks like a rabbit when your Chromebook powers on, because you just replaced the firmware, so your previous stock ChromeOS installation will no longer to be able to boot. Therefore, if you do nothing, your Chromebook will stuck at finding a compatible OS. All you need now is a USB storage drive with the latest FydeOS for you for Chromebook Pixel 2013 burned connected to your device. Reboot it and press Escape when you see the rabbit logo to invoke the boot menu option. Choose to boot from your USB device and you shall be able to boot FydeOS for you right off your USB storage drive. Once you are in FydeOS, you can follow the usual step to utilize the installer app and install FydeOS onto the hard drive of your Chromebook Pixel 2013 to complete the process. Now, I hope this video can help to explain how can you replace the firmware of your Chromebook Pixel 2013 and install FydeOS for you. If you are still confused or have any other question, please do not hesitate to reach out for us. Until next one, thank you for watching.